Just got Spiegel 90rock90online.com. Spiegel snubbed in the hallway, walking by and says, "Hey, how you doing? Let's get in." And a coworker of ours just looks at him and doesn't even utter a word.
You got ghosted.
What is that about?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's pretty simple. I mean, if somebody says hello to you, then respond.
Especially this person. I mean, there's people that I expect that from.
Mm-hmm.
And when I don't get a response, I know that all is right in the universe. Because if they did say hi, I'd be like, whoa.
Well, why am I on your radar?
What?
Why am I
why
on your radar?
Why are you saying hi right now? You're supposed to be the person that never says hi.
Cut your eyes at me and give me the finger.
Yes. I want that from some people. I expect that from some people. But this person.
Anybody in TV.
This person.
This person has had a long relationship with the show.
I think we need to get him on the phone. Do you want to say who it is?
It's WBAL reporter Phil Yacuboski.
Wow. What the F, Phil?
Phil.
Dude.
Fill us in, Phil. Phil with an F. Okay. Why you snubbing Josh? And don't think I haven't forgotten about you, son of a bitch. You pretending that you knew Peter Cullen, the voice of Optimus Prime. And you said you could arrange an interview with him. And I believed you all morning. I'm still not over it. And he made eye contact with you just to make sure we have our bases covered. Not like he didn't hear you.
No, he definitely heard me because we were passing in the hall like two canoes in the night. And he made eye contact with me. I said, "Hey, how's it going?" Like, it wasn't a low greeting. It was
right.
Definitely a high greeting. He couldn't have not heard it. And he just stared at me, then looked down and kept walking.
Wow.
I got to hold him. He's moving to a space where he can talk.
All right. Nice of him to accommodate us.
Joining us on the phone, Phil Yacuboski, WBAL AM. Good morning, Phil.
Villain.
Hey, good morning, everybody.
So what happened? Why did you snub me yesterday?
I really don't know what you're talking about, actually. I know I've passed you in the hall several times in the past few weeks, and I've always been cordial and said hello,
oh,
and yesterday
really?
I got the snub in reverse, so I just kept walking.
What are you talking about? I said to you, "Hey, how's it going?" You looked at me, didn't say anything, and then looked down and kept walking.
What's that about?
No, you didn't say that. You didn't say that. That's not accurate.
Oh, now we're going a little he said, he said.
So not only is snubbing, you're calling him a liar.
Are you hearing impaired? Because, you know, somebody down the hall would have heard me.
No, I'm not hearing impaired. Okay. I clean my earwax pretty frequently, unlike you, from what I understand.
And here we go. Here we go.
This is not a time to be doing shtick. You hear me, Yacuboski?
Wronged him.
Yeah.
Why did you snub him?
Hang on one second. Hang on one second. Okay. I have to move here. As you folks well know, I'm covering the funeral for President Bush today, so the Secret Service is moving us from one location to the other.
Oh, cool.
Herbert Walker wouldn't have snubbed Speaks.
Yeah,
tell you that much.
Said hello to him.
Would have said hello.
He was a polite man.
41 had presence and couth.
And you know who else? The dog also would have acknowledged.
That's right, Sully. Why?
Yes,
just Phil, just
absolutely.
Say why. Just what was the motive behind
it? Just be open and honest.
He clearly said hello to you. You clearly heard it. You looked him right in the eyes, looked down, and kept walking.
Why
that
do you
is not a proper exchange.
I don't recall there being a hello. There's usually just like an acknowledgement of one's presence, and then it's continued. But I don't remember this jovial hello that
Spiegel.
He's talking about, like, Santa, jovial.
He's gaslighting us. He's gaslighting us. You're trying to make us out to be crazy. No, I'm figured
out
your spider's web.
That is true.
You are gaslighting us. Oh, this is the same guy that had me going for an hour and 45 minutes that you knew the voice of Optimus Prime, Peter Cullen. So I know your wily ways, Phil. I know that you get inside of a head and plant a brain worm. You're not going to pull it off on Speaks. He's not as slow as I am, okay? So don't think you could pull that on the news genius, because it ain't me. Listen to him. He's a maniac, man.
Oh, he's unhinged. He's unhinged.
Oh, my.
Well, Phil, before we got you on, I was saying that there's a general animosity from the WBAL newsroom towards Josh. That's true, correct?
Why would there be that?
Or just disdain. A disdain for what he does over here.
I feel like you
we do real news. He doesn't do.
Oh,
news.
See, you
exactly
see,
what I
told
say.
You.
I'm going
that's
under
exactly
the board.
Exactly what I was
going
to say.
I told you.
I was going. I knew it. I was. I was going to
say.
Well,
tell me, how is this not real news? That's what I'd like to know. Explain that. Because you're an expert. So tell me. I want to learn from you.
Anytime you want to sit in the newsroom, we'll be more than happy to talk.
No, I want to learn now. We have time. I want to learn why this is not real news. This, you know. Teach me how to get better ratings. That's what I'd like to know.
Okay. Well, I can do that. Unfortunately, I can't do it right now.
Okay. All right. Well, send me a memo or something and tell me why this is not real news and how this show can get to number one. We are number one.
That's right.
Actually, yeah, I just saw the ratings. We are number one.
Okay. But I
that
guess...
That is great. That is great to hear.
Yes.
That is great to hear.
All right. Well,
my body is
Josh, maybe you and I should go to lunch sometime, and maybe we'll visit, like, the museum in Washington, or we'll sit down and we'll read some, you know, books all about the Associated Press and how to cover journalism. And yes. That. Would you like to do that?
No, because I'm well aware of what to do. If you don't know my history. I didn't just walk into 98 Rock and start here, so...
Oh. Roasted.
You know, I have a long history.
Well, Josh, maybe you can give me the book on how to be funny. Unfortunately, I think it's probably blank.
Racist.
I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Racist.
Whoa. Okay.
Whoa. Phil, I'm not sure if you have any surviving relatives, brother. Yeah, dude, you need to text him. You
reach out to your loved ones.
Day. You better check the brakes on that car before you pull out of the spot, homeboy, because there's a good chance Yacuboski 1's going to go flying off of a cliff, Thelma and Louise style. Oh, you should see the face Josh is making right now. You have just chiseled your own gravestone, Phil. They are going to put the gas under the dirt.
Look, my whole career, I've been dealing with people like him, and that's fine. That's fine.
Oh.
All right, Phil.
Have a wonderful day.
Here goes Phil.
Covering the funeral. Next week, maybe I'll cover yours.
Oh! Yeah! Josh!
Coming up.
Wow.
Oh, my God. I am so turgid.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.